this afternoon to exchange and interchange with you some of my thoughts and some of my ideas. And I want to hear some of your thoughts, your ideas. This 7th annual African Summit is so powerful because it's been done for 7 years. I am a preacher, a Bible believer, Christ-centered preacher. Those who are immigrant Africans, now it's time to raise your voices, take hold to the potential that you have, come together and really, really make a difference, both here in the U.S. and across the world. I sincerely believe that continually, we who are of African descent are in a pivotal position relative to global politics and the global economy. Just one example of that is occurring right now in this immediate space in Washington, D.C. and the U.S. Congress, where there are 43 members of the Congressional Black Caucus. And we stand united with one voice. And we have told the Senate and we told our House colleagues they like to call themselves the Gang of Eight. And we know a little bit about gangs here in Chicago. So we're not intimidated by gangs. So we've told them in no uncertain terms, unequivocally, that if they don't restore the diversity visas to this SB-144, the Senate immigration bill, that there would not be one Black Caucus member to vote for that bill when it came to the House. I told my colleague and my friend, Luis Gutierrez, well, we met on the bill. He came to my office to be on the bill. And I told him, in the strongest way that I know how, I said, Luis, if this bill comes to the floor of the House without the diversity visas as a part of it, then I'm going to puke on that bill. And I meant exactly what I said. Schumer has gotten a message, and others have gotten a message. And so they're working out some kind of arrangement. But we still have not reached a final point of an agreement. Now, why do I take these positions? Again, we're at a different level. Frankly, I told a meeting yesterday of the CDC Immigration Task Force that I have mixed feelings about this bill. Yeah, I'm going to be honest and frank with you now. I can't come up here and bull-jive you as I express how I feel from the pits of my soul, because we are an African people. And we have to be truthful for one another. Yeah. Our future depends on us being truthful and forthright for one another in the spirit of our ancestors. I saw in my head mixed feelings about this bill, you know, about this whole approach. I understand and I support the efforts of the immigrants and the efforts to get parity and fairness in the whole immigration processes of the United States government. I get that and I'm with that. But on the other hand, I kind of lament the fact that this bill will, in essence, have unintended consequences, and that it will keep a vibrant, vicious, in some ways, and vigorous brain drain in the continent. Some of you might not want to hear that. But we can't all get on the boat, or on a plane, and come here to America, and forget, and leave Africa in some ways in a desperate state that it really is in. Where right now, we're seeing not just European exploiters, but Asian exploiters. Because we have left Africa wide open and vulnerable, where anybody with an idea and some muscle and a few bucks can come in and reproduce their own brand of colonialism on the continent. I am an Africanist. I am an Africanist unashamedly. I'm proud to be an Africanist. And proud to serve with those who know that Africa is not a continent that yearns for aid, but it's a continent that demands trade. We have to build the economy, the African economy. And so I'm on the bandwagon for the immigration, for the diversity leasing thing, for eliminating the incarceration without legal counsel of those who come into this country by other than legal means. However, there are very few Africans who have come to this country illegally. Most members of the African immigrant community come with better education than other immigrant groups. Most African immigrants come to this nation with more of a capacity to contribute to this nation and to the world. And if you would look at just the power of the remittances that go back to the homeland, the remittances of the African immigrant group far exceeds the remittances of other immigrant groups. Multiple times. So the African immigrant group is a very, very powerful force. And I would hate to see that energy, that power, that force singled in, aimed at creating a life of privilege and the ability to purchase objects and goods, consumable items. I hate to see all that power just limited to that. When our call should really be, how are we going to develop Africa for Africa?